they would also gain from this cooperation. So on this note, I would just say welcome to this historic event. Thank you, Togbe Afede, for your effort. I would have to mention, I'm just a contractor.
Another big round of applause to the Honorable Volta Regional Minister. We continue with Agbogbomefia and President of the Volta Region House of Chiefs.
Mr. Bon Jamon. Our distinguished municipal and district executives, MPs here present, service commanders, my regional house of chiefs, other chiefs, Mamau, Mananum, ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed a great honor. I want to thank you very sincerely for the warm welcome we always receive each time we visit you at your residence. We derive a lot of inspiration from your words of encouragement and from your words of support. Our first visit to you was on December 1, 2010, and I'm very happy that within 1 year we have achieved the objective of that very important first visit. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as I've always said and we know, in the pre-colonial era, the chiefs were absolute monarchs. We wielded executive, legislative, judicial, and military powers. Even though we have lost all of these to the central government, our important roles in development and in uniting our communities cannot be overemphasized. My colleagues and I'm talking to chiefs of the region, hold a view that development that brings prosperity to the people, development that brings enhanced living standards, jobs, and incomes, is the desire for our people, is the most important desire of our people, and is essential for peace and stability. Of course, there's abundant evidence that almost every conflict in Africa is a fight over limited resources. We believe government is a shared responsibility. So rather than sit and watch our people fight over limited resources, we have a commitment to helping the central government to expand available resources and opportunities. Ladies and gentlemen, as the Honourable Minister has stated, China and Ghana have had relations for many years, in fact, dating since July 5, 1960. Our first president, Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, and China's Chairman Mao laid solid foundations for friendship between the two new republics. We appreciate and would like to thank Your Excellency for the Chinese government's continued support for the development of our country. Ghana has benefited from Chinese support in many ways that cannot be enumerated here. We here are following the footsteps of our illustrious founding fathers. My personal ties with China started on May 10, 2005. When I visited the then Chinese ambassador and expressed desire to lead a Volta delegation to China. That visit, very historic visit, took place between August 28th and September 8, 2005. An important result of that visit is the Sunan Power Plant that we all are aware of. And I'm happy to say that as we are talking today, the chairman of Shenzhen Energy Group, backed by a high power delegation from Shenzhen Municipal Government, are arriving in the country about this time to look at the possibility of a second phase for the power plant project and look at the possibility of establishing other industrial projects in Ghana. And again, together with China Africa Development Fund, which is a partner in the power plant project, we are looking at other opportunities in aviation, in tourism, in real estate, and etc. Your Excellency, we owe a lot of what we are achieving in this regard to your support, which you've always expressed to us. On 22nd September, as the regional minister said earlier, 27 of us chiefs, politicians, and businessmen from the Volta region went to Tunisia. We had the support of the embassy, we had the support of the China-Africa Business Council that represented here, and of course, we were very warmly received in Tunisia. The very initial reception gave us reason to believe that we have a lot to look forward to in the new emerging relationship. We took place of interest, signed a memorandum of intent, and even signed an agreement with the Chinese university, that is the Ningxia Medical University, which has a large faculty in traditional medicine, among others. Your Excellency, let me take the opportunity to emphasize to you that our region and our country is ready. We want to learn from the Chinese economic success story. As I said during your last visit to the Volta region, our region is a treasure trove of very important minerals, among them gold, diamond, copper, lead, iron, and oil and gas. The region also has fertile agricultural lands, enormous potentials for large-scale fish farming, large deposits of clay for brick and ceramic production, extensive salt deposits along the coast, and of course the largest variety of tourist attractions. These potentials, Your Excellency, are largely untapped. This is why the Volta Development Agent Department, the Volta Regional House of Chiefs, established the 5-year Volta Region Development Plan that is being implemented through the Volta Region Development Agency to open up all of these opportunities for exploitation. And it is the pursuit of this objective of opening up our region that led us to discuss with His Excellency the Ambassador the possibility of a twinning relationship between the Volta region and a region or a province of China. We're happy, Your Excellency, that today we are marking the formal realization of this dream, this objective. We'd like to invite our Chinese friends, both from Ningxia and outside of Ningxia, to take advantage of the favorable investment environment in this country, our promising natural resource sector, and of course the improved network of industrial infrastructure to invest in the Volta region. We as chiefs are committed to doing all we can with the support of our political leadership to bring development to our people. As I said, happiness is the essential objective of life, without which the essence of living is lost. And of course, without development, we can't have that happiness. And that is why this day is a historic one, very important for us. And I want to thank all who have made it possible. I want to thank His Excellency once again I want to thank my very good friend, Mr. Su, who is a native of Venetia, and has given special attention to this effort. Pictures of the region. You have commitment to the region. Your presence here tells me that forward to this day is bringing us a lot of great years from now, 10 years from now. We can look at with pleasure at what.
Take some remarks. His Excellency, we welcome.
Now, here to officially sign the agreement between the Volta Region of the Republic of Ghana and the Ningxia Great Autonomous Region of the People's Republic of China on the establishment of a friendship region's relationship. And we jointly witnessed the first ever treaty relationship of our two countries. This is an important step towards the history of our bilateral relations. Treaty relationship between regions is an important part of our bilateral relationship between our two countries. Volta Region and the Ningxia Great Autonomous Region are to play a pioneering role in exploring the great potentials of our bilateral cooperation at a localized level with more direct participation of the two peoples, business communities, and the various institutions of our two countries. Through the efforts made by both regions, with the coordination by the embassy and the support from governments and authorities of the two sides, I'm glad that we have now made it a reality. Today, we also have a delegation from the U.S., headed by Mr. Zhang Yizhong, Vice CEO of the Ningxia Volta Metropolitan Group with us to witness the signing of the important agreement. The declaration is also to seek opportunities for investment and collaboration in this country. The signing of this agreement is just a start of the many more corporations and exchanges in various fields to take place. I firmly believe that the parties of this agreement will make every effort to move forward and bring about tangible benefits to the two peoples. Ladies and gentlemen, Ghana is one of the first countries in the Sub-Saharan region to establish diplomatic ties with China. Over the last 50 years, the bilateral relations between our two countries have been developing steadily, especially the visit paid by His Excellency the President of the Republic of Ghana in September last year. During this visit, the two leaders of our two countries made great consensus in developing our bilateral relations. Now, we are working hard to realize the consensus reached by the two leaders last year. And I hope that you have already noticed China has made great efforts and will make still more efforts to help the Ghanaian people, Ghanaian brothers and sisters, to develop your economy. Both China and Ghana are developing countries. We have every reason to support each other, to learn from each other, so as to reach the goal of common prosperity. Ladies and gentlemen, may the friendship between China and Ghana last forever. May the friendship between Africa and Asia last forever. May the cooperation between regions move on from strength to strength. Long live Ghana, long live China. That's your all.
We invite and Honorable Regional Minister, supported by Vice President.
Thank you.
Relations between the Volta region of Ghana and Ningxia of the People's Republic of China.
Thank you, and esteemed Deputy Regional Minister of the RCC. What this region needs. We are beginning a very important journey, and the best part of it is that it is not a political engineered project. It is not the traditional authority engineered project, but it is a collaboration. I always say, when you have the traditional authority involved, it means it is permanent. So this is not for any particular political dispensation. The Volta region transcends all that, and we believe this will take us forever and ever. And if something is going to be good, it starts from the morning. And it is just coincidence that at the time of this signing, there are 18 counties, or what we call districts, in Asia region. And we have 18 districts in the Volta region. So what we want to do is to link each district to a county. By God's grace, we will be having some few more. When that happens, we'll know how to divide it. But what may be happening is that whoever is carved today will share the county with whoever they are linked with. That would be the best way of solving this. I want to say, even at this beginning, even before the ink has dragged on this agreement, we have seen positive steps in the development of these two very, very good friends, Volta Region and Ningxia province. Through the instrumentality of His Royal Highness and his team, we have a group from China that is going to invest in this region. In fact, when I hear the amount of investment, I get confused. And it's such a big project in agriculture and agro-processing, rabbit tree, a lot of whole many things. We need land. So I know Togbe has briefed the House of Chiefs. Please release land. Then, this morning, I had a Balta petrochemical company from Ningxia, that's our own brothers, coming to greet us and are part of this team. They are involved in oil and gas exploration. I told them the Volta region is on oil and gas.
Sure.
So they have come home. We will do everything possible to facilitate it that they begin exploration of oil and gas in the Volta region. And to make things even better, the Volta River, we are named after the Volta River.
Yes.
And for Ningxia, their life depends on the Yellow River. So both of us are dependent on these natural God-given rivers. They have exploited there to the extent that Ningxia is a desert, but you won't see sun. It's green. We have the Volta, and we still see sun. Now that we have our brothers who know how to do it, we're going to make sure that the Volta region becomes very green. Fisheries, animal husbandry, agro-processing, all those. These are the opportunities for rice. We have the land, they have the expertise. And I believe those of us in the Southern Volta know how the Chinese in the past helped us develop our rice fields. So it's going to be a feature now. I want to say that great, great credit, as I said earlier, should go to the Agbogbomefia and President of the House of Chiefs and the traditional leadership. Because as I said earlier, this was their baby, and it only needed a political collaboration to work. And that is what we are doing, and will continue to do. And I want to assure the Volta Region Development Agency and the Volta Region House of Chiefs that my DCs, MCs, and the Volta Regional Coordinating Council is ever prepared to support any scheme, individually by any chief or traditional area, or collectively by the Volta Region House of Chiefs. We can only move forward if we remain partners. That one, nothing can change it. I want to thank Mamaga Akosua and our brother Kufu, but our people say, Echike Mame, Eyeyame, Ozeme. Is that not it?
Yes.
They love us, so they are ready to become part of us. And I want to thank them especially for their sponsorship of the screening of the trip to Ningxia on Ghana television yesterday. I think some of us saw it, but those of us at this side of the region did not see it. But it's very good. I think I couldn't see it myself. I was on the way from Cape Coast that night. So, but we want to thank them very much. And I want to exhort our people, if people, excuse me to say, who are not traditionally our people, are doing so much, then we who own it should demonstrate that it is our project. Thank you very much, Mr. Kufo and Mamaga Akosua. The ambassador, that the Volta region is ready to work together with Ningxia, with province, and that we will do everything possible to keep our part of the bargain and even more. I want to announce that, having been there, we are expecting a high-powered delegation from Ningxia in the region, led by the governor. They will be here today, but will be here early next year. The ambassador has begun to look at the calendar to see a suitable time that they will have time to enjoy the Volta region. So we should be expecting to have another high-powered visitors very soon. And that one, they will be staying for some time, and Your Excellency, I can assure them of the traditional Volta hospitality. They will not want to go back. On that note, I want to thank you all for making time to be here. Republic of Ghana, long live the People's Republic of China.
Amen.
God bless us all.
Volta region team, and those of us who can join, and we all come back, those of us here, we all come back to sit down. Well, it's nice. Thank you. The same is to the heads of agencies and departments in the region, Volta region, to launch a program called Kamma. Has been changed of this. It's very, very important. This very Friday of December. The time is 9 o'clock in the morning. So you please take note. To allow our organ meeting. Thank you. Thank you.
Of course.
Photo.
Bonjour.